Hey there. In this video, I'm going to explain how you set up a PostgreSQL database with a Django Docker application. The reason I'm making this video is because somebody on my Udemy course asked a question in the Q&A. I think his name was Imran. He asked a question about how to set up the application that we create in the course with PostgreSQL. And in the course, I use Vagrant to set up the set up the development server that we work on in the course. However, it's actually quite an involved process to set up PostgreSQL in Vagrant. You have to create quite a long bash script and configure all different kinds of things on the Vagrant server. It's a lot easier to get this set up if you're using Docker to run your application. It's literally just a few changes in the project. So in this video, I'm going to go through the steps to convert a existing Docker Django application to use PostgreSQL. If you don't have an existing Docker application, then that's fine, because I'm going to provide one in the links in this video that you can just clone from GitHub and you can get started where I am starting from. Okay, so let's begin. We're going to start by heading over to the link to the BYOB Profiles REST API Docker project, which is a project that I created in a previous YouTube video, which I'll also link in the description of this video. But if you head over to this on GitHub, and you basically just want to clone this to your local machine. So I'm going to clone this down to my demo workspace here. Git clone. And this is basically a simple Django REST framework application that just has an API that I create in the build your own backend Udemy course. Okay, so once it's cloned, we're gonna open this in our Atom editor or whatever text editor you wanna use. And then I'm gonna show you the changes that we're gonna make to the source code. Okay, so let's just take a quick recap over the code that's in here. So we have the SRC project, which has a standard Django application, which in it is just a simple Django app with a profiles API app that basically is just a basic REST API using the Django REST framework. We also have our Docker Compose here, which consists of one single service that runs our run server command for our Django project just to get our code up and running. So let's just go ahead and use Docker and just type Docker Compose up. So we're just gonna see what the current state of this is. So it may take a bit longer for you if you haven't already got the images cached on your machine. So you might wanna pause the video and wait for that Docker up or Docker Compose up command to complete. But once it's complete, you should see the URL that we can use, or we actually need to access it on our localhost URL, and it's on port 80. And you can see that the application is installed and running here. You can see the outputs coming in the terminal window that we have here. Okay, so that's the existing project. So now we're gonna modify this to add a PostgreSQL database. So I'm gonna just do Control C here to stop this. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna modify our Docker Compose to pull down a PostgreSQL image that we're gonna use to run alongside our web image that we can basically connect to as our database. So at the bottom of the Docker Compose file, let's create a new service called DB. So type DB colon. And I'm just gonna make this a little bit bigger so it's easier for people to read. Increase font size. There we go. Okay, so we've got our DB here, DB service, and that's gonna be adjacent to our web server. So it's important that there's the same number of spaces in between the web and DB. And what we're gonna do is, unlike here where we chose to just build from the current directory because we're building the Docker file that's in our project, we're actually gonna pull an image from the internet. So you can look for the Postgres image that's in the Docker Hub, and you basically just want the name, which is simply just Postgres. But if you go to hub.docker.com, you can search for all different kinds of images, all different kinds of databases. If you wanted to do this with MySQL, then you could do this quite easily with MySQL or MySQL, as some like to call it. But basically, this is just the hub of all the Docker images. And we're going to find our Postgres image. And let's just copy that and let's type image here, Postgres. Okay, so that's the what this will do is it will basically pull in a DB image running PostgreSQL, and it will run that alongside our container. There's one more change that we need to make. We need to make the DB image accessible by our web image or our web service. Sorry, so we want to make this. We want to basically say that this service depends on this service because this one needs to be running before this will start, otherwise it's going to error with saying the database cannot be found or something like that. So the way we do that is we add a new item to our web service, and it's called depends underscore on. Okay, and then you basically just tell it what other services this service depends on. And that way, when you run Docker Compose up, it knows that you need to start the DB service first, followed by the web service. And it also knows that the web service should be able to access the DB service via a TCP connection and basically resolve the host name. So it will automatically, if you're on the web service, it will automatically allow it to connect to the DB service by simply typing the host name DB. Okay, so now that we've made that change, let's save this file. And the next thing we need to do is we need to add a new dependency to our requirements. And the reason we do this is because we're going to be setting up our Django project to use the PostgreSQL backend, which requires the, it's called the PSYCOPG2 library. So let's type that PSYCOPG2. And I have no idea how to pronounce that. I'm sure there is a way, but I'm not gonna try it on this video. So we're gonna do, we're gonna add this PSYCOPG2 dependency, and we're gonna pin it to the version 2.7.3.2. And you don't need to do this pinning if you don't want. I'm just doing this because it means anyone else that follows the video, there's not going to be any changes or updates or anything that makes the steps any different. Okay, so now we can save this file. And the next step we need to do, and the final step, is we need to modify our settings file within, so it's within SRC profiles project settings. And we basically want to change this. We want to scroll down and find the databases section here. And we want to change this to reflect our new PostgreSQL database. And the way that you do that is, I'm just going to minimize the side window so you can see the full screen. There you go. Okay, the way that you do this is we're just going to change this engine here, and we're going to type PostgreSQL. As our new engine. And then we're gonna just remove this bit here, which basically says the name of the old database. And we're just gonna put in Postgres. And then in the user, we're gonna put in Postgres. And in the host, we're gonna put in DB. If you remember in our Docker Compose file, we had the depends on, that means this host name will resolve to this service when it's running. So we can just use the word DB there. And then the port, we're gonna use the default port of 5432, which is the default Postgres port. Okay, so now what we need to do is save this file, and now we can go ahead and run our Docker Compose to bring up our service. All right, so the first thing we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to run a database migration. So in the previous video, I explained how to set this project up and how to do all of this. So basically what you want to do is you just want to type docker compose run, and then the name of the service, and then we're going to type python src/profiles/project/manage.py and then migrate. Okay, and what this will do is Docker Compose will run this service, which because it has a dependency on this service, would also run this service. And then from the web service, it will call the manage.py script and it will run migrate, which will run the database migration and set up all the tables that are required for our project in the new PostgreSQL database. Let's go ahead and hit enter there. And again, if you don't already have the database cached in your system, then this may take a while for this to run because it needs to download all the required images and stuff. But as you can see, I already have it cached. And in fact, I already have ran the migrations because I practiced this before I did this video. So it says that there's no migrations to apply, but in your one, it should have a list of migrations that have been applied. Okay, so next we can finally go ahead and run Docker compose up. And this will start our Docker container, which will basically bring up our application. And then we can go and if I refresh this, you can see that it still works. And if I just do, or it still has the data that I created in my previous PostgreSQL database. But if you want to go ahead and create a new user, just call this Mark, and then we'll just give it the password awesome1. And you can see that it successfully creates users and it still works just as it did before, except this time it is using the PostgreSQL or the PostgreSQL database. Okay, so that's how you convert an existing Django application that is using a SQLite database to use a PostgreSQL database with Docker. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found it useful. If you have any questions or comments or anything, then please let me know in the comments section of this video. And otherwise, I'll see you next time.